second year in a row for Lehigh and Coach Higgins in the 1AA playoffs. Last year, upsetting Richmond in the first round, then lost to UMass.
And if there's one quarter Joe Gardy has to be concerned about, is Lehigh's production in the third quarter. They've outscored their opponents in the third quarter 111-29.
The third quarter, as Marty said, is owned by the Mountain Hawks from Lehigh. Those are tremendous numbers when you consider what this team has done this season. A bouncing ball off the hand of Ronald Jean. Ronald Jean looking for a gap and brought down at the 20-yard line. So the Mountain Hawks will start first and 10, led out by their quarterback number 17, Phil Stambaugh. The numbers for Gene, boy, he's got to have a big, big second half.
Roy Edkin, number 98, down there to make the stop for the special team.
This will be the first snap from scrimmage in the second half. Right to work, going airborne. Far side, Stambaugh connecting with Cody Fedorcha for a gain of 6, second down and 4.
Fedorcha is going to run it down and out. You take what the defense gives you, and he's going to get credit for picking up 6 yards.
Fedorcha, third catch of the game, has 30 yards. He had great numbers coming in, did Fedorcha. 67 catches, 769 yards, and 8 touchdowns. The leading receiver for Lehigh. Near side on the ground is Ronald Jean. Jean should have enough for the first down, driven out by number 3, Robert Thomas. Robert Thomas getting to Ronald Jean, but not before they move the sticks.
From the low angle, watch number 9, he's a free safety. Ashton Longer, he's going to fly in there. What you got to do is you got to come from the outside in so that your pursuit can get it. Good, strong running by Gene, and they're going to pick up the first down.
Played 22 seconds of this third quarter. You win, you go on. You lose, and a very successful season comes to an end. Snap out of the shotgun, the ball is loose, and it appears to be, and yes it is, Ronald Jean able to recover, but a big loss on the shotgun snap.
Well, James Mayer's back there to disrupt it, and then he's going to come in, push the quarterback out of the way. You see the snap, then ball lets it go through his hands. Now the fight for the ball. Look at James Mayer. He's going to come in, and they're going to lose 11 yards on the play.
Setting it up for second down and 21 for Lehigh. The ball at the Mountain Hawk 19. Twins split out far side. Inside handoff to Bill. Big fullback Brett Snyder plows ahead, just shy of the 25, picking up about 5.
Jim Emanuel, number 44, in on the stop. We talked about Emanuel. I really believe that next year in the NFL, with the right team, he could make a positive impact on special team play.
And I think also, Marty, as you said, he's really playing out of position, being the middle linebacker. He's got that quickness to be on the outside. He could be a very dynamic special teams player in the NFL. Third down, 15. Stambaugh under the rush, steps up, gets it off, downfield, tipped by Robert Thomas, and Rick Moore almost came up with that deflected pass.
But good pressure by the defensive line. They're running a lot of stunts up there, confusing Lehigh's offensive linemen. Watch the pressure by the defensive line. Stambaugh's going to throw it up for grab. Robert Thomas, number 3, good vertical jump to knock it down.
Third punt of the afternoon for number 36, Jay Heibel. He's averaging 35 and a half in this game. Gets it off, Billy Morales. Morales drops it at the 35, regains. Morales tries to spin at the 40, but it's covered and dropped by number 50, Tom Oropeza. 40-yard punt, 7-yard return for Morales.
And what Morales has to do is really start to concentrate. Joe Grady's got to bring this, his returners over to tell him, hey, one of these times we're going to fumble the ball. It's going to cost us something. Already in the first half, two mistakes cost them 10 points. Good look at number 11, Billy Morales.
Excellent field position for the Flying Dutchman. First possession of the second half. You mentioned Morales, a transfer from Nassau Community College, which is right across the street from Hofstra University. Hand off to Jimmy Jones. Jimmy Jones is stuffed after a 2-yard pickup. Ian Eason has played dynamite on defense this afternoon for Lehigh.
Eason comes up, makes another stop.
Eason is a senior, as is Jimmy Jones, number 20 from Freeport, Long Island.
Terrific numbers too, 61 tackles for the season, 1 sack, 2 interceptions.
On second down and 8, Hofstra with trips to the near side, send Jones in motion far side. Over the middle, wide open, Morales in and out of his hands and nearly picked off by Bryant Appling, number 35.
Lehigh's going to make an adjustment at the line of scrimmage right prior to the snap. They're going to drop two of their defensive linemen off into coverage and only rush two. Billy Morales trying to run before he catches the ball. But again, Lehigh only rushing two, dropping 9 back into coverage. Again, they go with the two defensive linemen. There's a good look at it. 9 players in coverage.
Hofstra spreads 5 wideouts. Shotgun Carmazzi. Thrown behind Kamal Roy, who slipped. It would have been enough for the first down.
Wow, you should have all day back there. You got 5 on 2. No reason to rush the ball. Carmazzi's going to go back and watch. No pressure, none at all. And then he throws behind Kamal Roy, number 8.
James McClary, number 16, to do the punting. Dan Zorger will snap. Remember, they had a tough time on the exchange in the first quarter. It led to a Lehigh touchdown. The exchange is good. The kick is off. Fair catch. Josh Snyder fumbles the football. And who's got it? It's still loose. And Lehigh will keep it.
It bounced right through the hands of Pudge Brown.
Avon Mack, number 8, on the recovery.
Snyder can't find a handle. Watch Pudge, number 43, come into your picture. He's going to try to run with it. Instead, you should just fall on it.
Mack does.
Watch Adam Brown. He comes into your picture. I think I got me a touchdown. No! Can't even find the handle.
Avon Mack, Johnny on the spot. Reception is made by Bruce Peltzer. Very active in this throwing offense.
Peltzer's going to get slammed after picking up a couple yards by number 26, Doug Shanahan.
5th catch of the season for Peltzer. Coming into the lineup, number 80, Dustin Grande at tight end, replacing number 87, Brian Endler.
Give Peltzer 5 yards on the reception.
21-0, Illinois State over Colgate in the second quarter. The winner of this game plays the winner of that game. Enough for a first down for the Mountain Hawks from Lehigh. Asher Longden, the tackle, but not before they will move the sticks.
Ron Jean's going to cut right behind defensive tackle number 91, Jim Magna. You see Kevin Higgins. Watch the strong run by Kevin Jeans. He sees 91, he cuts back outside, back inside, and Rob Levitis, along with Joe Todd, makes the stop.
I have fallen in love with Ronald Jean. I just like the way he plays the game. Hard, got a lot of heart. He's hoping to play the next level, the NFL. Snyder, the far side. Boy, tackled by Asher Longden.
Ron Jean's going to do an excellent job this time. Watch how he's going to block. on Rob Leviticus as we look at Snyder, number 7, outside, and he picks up the first down.
Marty, Rob Leviticus came off the field. He's holding his left arm, replaced by Casey Mahoney.
Right side of your screen. Watch number 2. He's only 5'6". Blocked him out of the picture. He was so good.
Athletic trainers attending to Leviticus near sideline. Looking for the home run. Stample! Cut back and he catch. Yes or no? Intercepted. What a great pick by Lindy Washington. Taking it away from Cody Fedorcha.
Fedorcha's going to come down with it. At the same time, Lindy Washington is going to reach in and grab it. And it's an interception. Going to fake outside. Now he's going to unload deep. Fedorcha's 83, cuts back inside, makes the adjustment. You think he has it? No! Lindy Washington comes up with an interception.
14th time this season that Stambaugh has been picked off, and he was going for his favorite target, Fedorcha, but Lindy Washington, the transfer from the University of Maryland out of Largo, Maryland, the senior, making the big defensive play. 10:53 left in this third quarter. Jimmy Jones nearly stripped, but able to hold on, nearly stripped, tackled by Abdul Byron.
Jimmy Jones gonna have to put that ball away. Aggressive play by the defensive Lehigh. Jimmy Jones carrying the ball outside. Already has fumbled one time today. Takes a very strong hit by Abdul Byron, number 24 for Lehigh.
10:22 left, third quarter. Klein Dutchman with the ball, looking to add to a 4-point lead. Jones still on his feet into the secondary. Brought down at the 42-yard line by Brendan Moore. Lehigh has a player slow to get up.
Watch Jimmy Jones. Good, strong blocking by the right side of that offensive line, and then strong leg drive by Jimmy Jones.
Speaking of legs, James Young, there he is, hobbles off. The junior from Morristown, New Jersey, was injured on the last play. First and 10, Flying Dutchman from their own 42-yard line. Exactly 10 minutes left, third quarter, 17-13. Hofstra over Lehigh in the first round of the 1AA playoffs. Flying Dutchman was seeded third, Lehigh 14th. Looking for the opening, Jones near side, still on his feet, crossing the 45 to the 44. Dropped by number 9, Kevin Joseph.
This is all Jimmy Jones. Has to bounce it back outside to pick up some positive yards. Give him credit for picking up 4.
The workhorse running back, Jimmy Jones, since the injury to Vaughn Sanders back at UMass.
Puts him over 900 rushing yards for the season.
Trips to the far side on 2nd down and 6. The ball at the Hofstra 46. Quarterback draws. That play, slowing it down from the get-go, was number 98, Jason Stanley, and number 30, Matt Salvatera.
Salvatera is number 30, going to make the stop. Watch the pressure. Again, Lehigh makes the adjustment. They're only going to rush 2 defensive linemen. Carmazzi's going to try to stretch it outside, and there's the stop by Moore, number 20.
Loss of 2, 3rd and 8. Again, the Lehigh fans on their feet. Trips far side. With time, drill. Oh, what a breakup. A tremendous breakup by Matt Salvatera.
Salvatera is number 30. We talked about his aggressive play. He's only a freshman. Number 30, Carmazzi goes back. Offensive line giving him excellent time. Steps up into the pocket. And Salvatore right there, number 30, knocks it down.
That was his 11th breakup of the season, Salvatera. Fair catch called for by Josh Snyder. 28-yard punt. No return. The ball back in the hands of the Mountain Hawks when we come back.
Part-time studies. It's all about time. Call 1-800-HOFSTRA.
100 years, one special night. Join us for Sports Illustrated's 20th Century Sports Awards as our editors reveal their selections for the greatest athletes and achievements in the past 100 years at Madison Square Garden, December 2nd. VIP tickets include entree to the pre-awards party of the century with the athletes. Call toll-free 1-877-833-3VIP. Be there among the greatest collection of sports heroes ever assembled.
8:06 remains third quarter. The Flying Dutchman leading it by the score of 17-13. And here come the Mountain Hawks charging it out. They'll go with a no huddle right from the get-go.
Look for Ron Jean to get more active in the game. He has scored two touchdowns in seven out of the 11 games. Instead, they go to Snyder right up the middle.
Going with the big fullback, Brett Snyder, the senior, whose brother is Josh, who's a sophomore. Clay didn't really get much, maybe a yard. Call it second down and nine. Once again, no huddle. Lehigh. Snyder still in there. Now Ronald Jean comes on the field, and running it off will be number 14, Rick Moore. Stanball, the quarterback, number 17. He didn't run off. They thought he was going to run off. A little trickery there. On the far side, Rick Moore makes the catch.
Again, Rick Moore running out. Stops right before he goes out of bounds. He's still a live player out on the field. You don't see him out there, but number 14 is Ricky Moore. He makes the reception and the first down.
I like that play again. Kevin Higgins, second time in the game I've liked his play, even though I didn't think Ricky Moore was going to stay on the field. From the 44-yard line, Ronald Jean. Ronald Jean beginning to heat it up, and they're giving him the ball now, Marty. You said they need him to be active. Casey Mahoney making the stop.
Well, when you look at their record, they've won 21 games in the last 2 years. Why? Number two. Ron Jean, he has rushed, and going all the way back to last season, 12 out of the last 13 games, he's rushed for over 100 yards. Today, only 51.
Not even halfway to his average level. Oh, they're mixing it up very, very well right now. First down catch by Cody Fedorcha.
Fedorcha, again, take what the defense gives you. If your corners are going to play off to the soft corner, what you have to do is tell your quarterback, I'm going to run down, I'm going to turn out. Hopefully he's going to deliver it, which he does, and you pick up another first down.
There is Fedorcha, the senior, 6 foot, from Slampington, Pennsylvania. Fake to Gene, play action, pressure, Stanball still with it. Over the middle, intended receiver for Dorcher. Check out the flag at the 48-yard line. Looks like holding will be called on Steve Ludwig, number 77, the senior from Wayne, New Jersey.
Kerry Williams getting back there, putting pressure on the quarterback. Ludwig, number 77, 6'6", 278, a senior, gets called for holding. Stanball is going to go back. Watch the pressure by number 96, Kerry Williams. There's the hole. The penalty comes out, and they're going to back him up.
Illegal push in the back on the offense. Replay, first down.
Illegal push in the back.
who was pushed illegally by 77 Ludwig, whose brother is Michael Ludwig, number 59, the senior center.
Wow, first and 30.
On the run, Stample. Oh!
I'm thinking, Carl.
I'm thinking. A look and a listen. Ricky Moore, reception.
Daddy, knock him to the ground.
Second daddy of the game. Earlier, Tom Herrera getting one.
Tom Herrera got one earlier.
And now Lindy Washington getting a daddy. Reception is made short of the first down. Called in by number 87, Brian Endler. Third and short for Lehigh.
Third and three for Lehigh.
5:35 left third quarter. Hofstra with a four-point lead, 17-13. But Lehigh is on the move, and their fans letting them know. Once again, it led the Division I level of college football. But today, they have struggled on third down conversions. Dumped off, and I don't know if he's got it up. Robert Thomas, bring it down for Dorchin.
Going to be just shy. Kevin Higgins showed a great deal of confidence right before halftime.
What are you going to do now? It's fourth and one after a gain of two.
You got to go for it. It's too far for a field goal.
They'll probably go double tight end because they brought in Dustin Grande. They brought in the big fullback number 39, Brett Snyder. Key play in this game with 4:40 left third quarter, and now a timeout called by Phil Stambaugh.
Timeout, Lehigh. They're first.
That is the referee, Jack Winter. Remember, the Atlantic 10 officials while working this game. Jack Winter told you it's a TV timeout. We'll be back.
The most powerful name in news, Fox News Channel, on cable 24 hours a day. Fair and balanced with the most powerful names in news. Special Report with Brit Hume, the political show of record. The Fox Report with Paula Zahn, powerful information. The O'Reilly Factor, where news is a contact sport. Hannity and Combs, right battles left. The Cavuto Business Report, powerful business. Fox News Channel, the most powerful name in news. We report, you decide.
This moment of romance was brought to you by the Westbury Manor.
When is a cable company more than a cable company? When they have a staff like this. Technology like this. Choices like this. And a name like this. When is a cable company more than a cable company? When they give you more than cable. Cablevision.
Lehigh facing a fourth and one, trailing 17-13. Third quarter is winding down. The ball at the Hofstra 33-yard line. They had lined up the Mountain Hawks, but then quickly called for time to discuss this. They go with the double tight end. The big fullback, Brett Snyder, in front of Ronald Jean. Fake to Jean, they'll throw play action. They got the first down and more. Brett Snyder still on his feet. And Snyder spins inside the five and knocked down at the one by Lindy Washington.
What a great play selection right there by Kevin Higgins. 32 yards on the reception. Play action, here it comes. Fake it. Stambaugh is going to throw it out there to Snyder. Then watch Snyder. one missed tackle. Then the bounce, to stay in bounds, twist, takes it all the way down to the 2-yard line.
Actually, James Mayer, number 81, the touchdown saving tackle, and not Lindy Washington. First and goal, Lehigh, from the Hofstra 2-yard line. Ronald Jean waiting for an indication. He is not in yet.
Running behind the fullback, number 39, Brett Snyder. Jean's going to take it down inside the one.
James Magnum,
Ronald Jean made his way from Freeport, Bahamas to Boca Raton, and now in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania. His mom just abused him as a child. He told his mother he wasn't moving to New York, and now he's in a championship game. Still short.
Bill Sample, number 17, the ball carrier.
Setting it up for third and goal. If you enter the red zone against the Flying Dutchman, you will have to earn the touchdown.
Stay back.
No gain on the play.
No gain. So the ball still resting inside the 1-yard line. Lehigh down by 4 with 3:22 left on the clock, third quarter.
Of a yard on the play. Robert Thomas shoots in, backside, bottom of the pile.
Are you going for it? There's and Robert Thomas, or you bring in on Jaron Tate. Lehigh will go for the touchdown and forego the 3 points. Fourth and goal for Lehigh, down by 4.
An excellent job. He's the outside linebacker. He's going to ride the tight end. Keep pushing him. Keep pushing him. Stanball is going to go back left side. Watch Casey Mahoney. He's going to push the tight end. Keep pushing him. And he's out of bounds. Bruce Peltzer, been a favorite target all afternoon. He's going to run out of real estate. The ball's thrown up. He tries to make the reception. And a great play by the defense. Number 22, Casey Mahoney.
Casey Mahoney, the senior from Forked River, New Jersey. Trips spread to the near side. Hofstra pinned deep at its own 2. Jimmy Jones struggles to the 4.
Jimmy Jones, number 20.
Jason Stanley, number 98, stopping the play.
And if you're Lehigh right now, you need your defense to come up with 3 big plays. Try to pin the Dutchman down and try to make him kick into this very strong wind.
Kevin Higgins, the Patriot League Coach of the Year in 1995 and 98 in a dogfight on the road against the Flying Dutchman. Inside, 2 minutes left, third quarter. Carmazzi fakes, has a blocker in front. Carmazzi is crushed, crossing the 10 to the 13-yard line. Ian Eason, the senior linebacker, brings Carmazzi down, and Carmazzi slow to get up.
Carmazzi's going to get a great block downfield by number 88, Charlie Adams. You see Carmazzi slow to get up. Eason comes from behind him, probably landed on the ball, knocked the wind out of him.
And because time has stopped on the clock, Carmazzi will now have to come out for at least one play, which would bring in Rocky Butler, number 12.
Another look at it. Watch Carmazzi. This is the underneath option. Decides to hold on to the ball. Watch. Ian Eason, number 41, come into your picture. Slams him right there. And you see Carmazzi falls on the ball. Knocks the wind out of him. Second look at it. The option. Watch the blocking downfield, though. Billy Morales. Charlie Adams. But Carmazzi does pick up a first down.
still attending to the senior quarterback from Sacramento, California, the athletic training staff. That's Rick Zappala, who's got his back to you, bent over. Coach Joe Gordy now.
Come on, Gino.
Dr. Marie Hanache.
You guys, you're playing.
He thinks it's an assistant coach. Yeah, that's broke Wayne Corbett's record. He's in my office every friggin' day.
Hey, coach, that's our franchise right there. That's the franchise, coach.
Come on,
let me help the franchise.
Well, you hear Coach Joe Gordy and Steve Jackson exchanging franchise right over there. You know what? They're right. That is the franchise right there, number 19.
It really is. When you look at Rocky Butler, he's the quarterback of the future, only a sophomore.
He's from Allentown, Pennsylvania, is Butler, 6 foot, 190 pounds so far this year, completed 4 of 9 passes for 141 yards and 2 touchdowns.
But the one thing that they say about Rocky Butler, he can run the rock.
Pretty much would remind you of Caron Brown, who was here about 5 years ago. So Butler behind center, number 61, Dan Zorga, on first and 10. Jimmy Jones bouncing his way. And it's Butler. I follow Jones to the line of scrimmage.
See, I got faked out.
You don't want me on your side, do you?
Well,
I follow Jimmy Jones.
But watch the play action fake. Look, there it is. He hides it on his hip.
Even
Rocky Butler tries to get outside. Breaks one tackle. Breaks another.
Well, Gio Carmazzi will come back. Such a great fake. Even Ian Eason, the linebacker, went for Jimmy Jones, Marty.
You know what you call that? You call that an excuse.
Excuse. You have to be lucky to have an excuse. Hofstra spreading five, trips to the far side. Charlie Adams catching it. And Charlie Adams just tossed before he can get it going. Brendan Moore, number 20, combining with Matt Salvatierra, number 30.
Salvatierra out there at the cornerback position. He's number 30 for Lehigh. Comes up and makes the quick stop.
Less than 1 minute left in this third quarter of play. No scoring in this third quarter. And this is a Lehigh team that put 111 points on the board in the third quarter alone this season. They scored over 460 points. Third down and 5 for Hofstra from its own 19-yard line. In trouble. And stays in trouble. Dropped at the 15-yard line. Nico Carwell, number 5.
What you have to like about Lehigh is they're playing an attack defense. They're playing a dime situation. There's 6 defensive backs in there. And watch the pressure by the front 3. Carmazzi has nowhere to go. He gets flushed out of the pocket. And then Carwell comes up to make the stop and the sack. Number 5.
McClary on to do the punting to Josh Snyder in single safety. McClary has averaged 29 yards on 2 punts in this football game.
Come on, Jimmy, Jimmy.
This will leave McClary's foot from about his own 5-yard line. Lehigh will get great field position. Oh, and the wind catch in this one. Which way does it bounce? It takes a Lehigh bounce and down at the Hofstra 26-yard line.
13 yards on the punt. We talked about if Lehigh was going to make a move, they had to come up with a good defensive stand. They did that. McClary, 13 yards on this punt.
So Hofstra, who was able to stop Lehigh on 4th and goal from the 1, not able to get anything done on offense. Then McClary comes up with a 13-yard punt. They spotted at the 29-yard line with 18 seconds left in this third quarter.
And again, your defense, they have their back to the wall.
Stand ball for Dorcher. Bumped immediately by Lindy Washington. The clock will continue to run. And that should do it for this third quarter. Fedorcha has 6 catches for 60 yards. 1 second, and now no time left on the clock. Moments away from the start of the fourth quarter, and the Hofstra Flying Dutchmen are holding on.
Adam, Jason, and I invite you to Superscape 2000.
A Ranger celebrity charity event, Saturday, December the 11th at the Garden. Thanks to you,
At last year's event, we raised $100,000 for NYR Skate and the Christopher Reeve Paralysis Foundation.
Please join us for an all-star night of hockey at the Garden. Ticket prices start at just $10. Available at the Garden box office and Ticketmaster.
Support two great charities and a special night with the Rangers. The Super Skate 2000.
He's been called a missionary of the delicious by the New York Times.
It had the perfect amount of crunch.
He's been knighted by the French Republic for his writing on the art of good eating.
The meat is not aged enough.
Together, Ed Levine and Jeffrey Steingarten are two guys with great taste.
The food was so vivid, very special.
Not bad.
Watch Metro Eats with Ed Levine and Jeffrey Steingarten, Thursdays at 8:30.
Kathleen's Bake Shop has the best chocolate for cookies.
Only on Metro Learning.
This is Bacon Bacon.
When is a cable company more than a cable company? When they have a staff like this. Technology like this. Choices like this. And a name like this. When is a cable company more than a cable company? When they give you more than cable. Cablevision.
No scoring in the third quarter. After 45 minutes, Flying Dutchman still with a four-point lead. But Lehigh knocking on the door. Flying Dutchman, you see, get it going early on. But towards the end of the game, they have a little bit of trouble. Fedorchuk trying to skip and turn his jump his way. He got to the 25-yard line. Tell you, I like to have all the trouble that Hofstra has had this year with that little fade and still be ranked fourth in the nation. Not too many coaches with any sympathy.
Fedorchuk are looking like a matador out there.
Olé. Olé.
Again, good numbers today. Seven receptions, 62 yards.
Third down, 6 yards for Lehigh. Ball at the Hofstra 25-yard line, shotgun standoff, twins far side, fake to Ronald Jean. Under the pressure, and it's picked off! It is picked off by number 92, Damon Sinicroppi. Standoff trying to get rid of it rather than take the sack. He's picked off by Damon Sinicroppi.
James Mayer's going to get credit for the sack. Or the pressure. Now it's not a sack. He's going to throw it away. Another look at the pressure coming up front. Good coverage downfield. Stanball has nowhere to throw the ball. James Mayer, 81. Instead, he's going to try to throw it away. And what happens? Damon Sinicroppi comes up with an interception.
And not a shock to look at the stat sheet and see that it is Sinicroppi's first pick of the season. But wow, what a big turnover. Well, you heard from the sideline. Yes, it was great defense. Carmazzi right to work. Steve Jackson has the sliding catch at the 46-yard line.
A perfect bullet by Carmazzi to Jackson and a completion. Jackson now 9 receptions, 119 yards. Same pattern, timing, throw, and then the reception.
And Marty, one of the best things about that throw was low enough where Jackson could catch it, but not able to pick it off when it's that low to the ground. From the 46-yard line on a first and 10. Jones over the 45 to the 42. Ian Eason, the tackle.
What can you say about Ian Eason? As you take a look at Sinicroppi, 92, Jim Magna, 91. The defensive tackle's doing an excellent job. Plenty of football left as you see James Mayer on the left trying to slide in there behind him. Gets credit for the pressure.
Picked up 4 on the last play. Second down and 6 for the Flying Dutchman with trips left. Split out near side, number 8, Kamal Roy. Great drop by Mozzie. Billy Morales with a catch inside the 30-yard line, brought down by Brian Appling. But Billy Morales picking up some positive yardage for another Hofstra first down.
Watch Billy Morales, number 11. Plenty of time. That offensive line doing an excellent job. Billy Morales, middle of your screen, up, back, turns around, picks up 13 yards.
Has three catches, 35 yards for Billy Morales, the junior from Far Rockaway, New York. Looking to take advantage of the Damon Sinicropi INT. Hofstra goes trips left. Ramazzi rolls right. Drills wide open over the middle. Steve Jackson fights his way to the 9-yard line, brought down by Ian Eason, but not before Jackson picks up, Marty, 19 more yards.
Ching, 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 the money man. Isolation comes across the field. Number 21, Steve Jackson, again, a big-time reception, 19 yards.
Steve Jackson, 10 catches today, make it 83 for the season. All-time leading pass catcher in school history. Did that last week in the regular season finale against JMU, and it was a touchdown catch that set the record. With room, the fake, Carmazzi will pretty much be chased out of bounds, maybe lost a yard, chased out by number 20, Brendan Moore.
But again, Carmazzi's going to go back. He looks to his right, looks to his left. He slides down in the pocket. The maturity tells him, don't try to force anything. Take it out of bounds. Sets up a second. And goal.
Kevin Higgins looking on. Joe Gordy looking on. Coach Kevin Higgins needs a stop. It looked like Lehigh would drive and go into this and perhaps take a lead. And then Sinicropi picked off Stamball, who's about to be sacked. Second down and goal for Hofstra. 12:01 left, fourth quarter. Jimmy Jones can't find an alleyway and stacked up after perhaps a yard gain.
Jones, the ball carrier.
Trey Slayton, number 92, the ball stop.
Slayton slides in there to tell you Dan Zorger nowhere to go. Good play by the defensive tackle.
Marty, elsewhere, Youngstown State, first quarter leading Montana 3-0. Halftime, Illinois State leading Colgate 28-0. Have some other scores we'll get to after this play. Third down and goal. Ball still at the Lehigh 10-yard line. Trips left. Steve Jackson reaching back. Couldn't haul it in. Bring out Chad Johnson. This will be a 27-yard attempt. Johnson earlier in the game in the first quarter connecting from 21 yards. And that put Hofstra up at that point. Well, actually, Hofstra got on the board at that point, trailing 10-3. So Chad Johnson, should he make this three-pointer, would give Hofstra a seven-point advantage with 11:11 left in this fourth quarter. End zone look. Art Aselka will hold. Chad Johnson has been coming on of late. Last week banged home a couple. Today has banged home a couple. And the Flying Dutchman leading it 20-13 with 11:07 left.
Higgins' son,
Nothing even comes close.
Look at me.
A performance that burns.
That's the way I do it.
A story that ignites. Not your everyday movie. We show the movies that had to be made. Every day on Bravo. Catch a movie that'll stay with you long after your TV's dark.
Hofstra with a 7-point lead, courtesy of a Chad Johnson 27-yard field goal just moments ago. Carmazzi and company leading it with 11:07 left. The drive for the Flying Dutchman. The deep men, near side, Ronald Jean, number 2, far side, number 23, Jamal Bercher. But Chad Johnson has not given either of them an opportunity to return a kickoff. Doug Shanahan will come over and help on the kickoff. Good citizen, dropping it in the garbage rather than just tossing it on the ground. 11:07 left. You win, you play next week. You lose, pack the gear up. Short kick. Bercher fields at the 9. Bercher with a hole. Bercher still on his feet over the 35 to the 37. Robert Thomas making the tackle.
And if Joe Gardy has one concern going into the fourth quarter, it has to be the play of his special teams. Right here, poor coverage. Bercher, number 23, he's going to take it right up into the heart.
38-yard line.
Missed tackle. Good strong running. Robert Thomas, number 3, wrestles him to the ground.
Inside 11 minutes now. This is a first and 10 for Lehigh, showing trips to the near side. Mountain Hawks down by 7. Early on, led 10-0. Lofting it, catching it, and then knocked out by Robert Thomas is Rick Moore. The reception very close to a Lehigh first down at the Mountain Hawk 47-yard line.
If Lindy Washington, number 2, turns around, he can locate this ball. Stanball's going to throw out there to Ricky Moore. Watch number 2 trail into play. All he has to do is turn around. Could have made the interception. Nice strong pass, though. And a good reception by number 14, Ricky Moore.
Stadium scoreboard has shown that a first down has been made, but they'll bring the chains all the way across the field to measure to see, as Stanball will go talk to Coach Kevin Higgins.
Good numbers, 23 of 33, 230 yards. The one that's killing them is 2 INTs.
No touchdowns, first down for Lehigh. Elsewhere, NCAA, 1AA playoffs, Florida A&M 27-6 over App State. That's in the third quarter. Furman at the half leading UMass 14-10. UMass, the defending national champions. And at the half, Georgia Southern leading Northern Arizona by the score of 32-14. On the first down, Twins split out far side for Lehigh. Far side, can't catch up to that pass. Couldn't go up the ladder high enough was Cody Fedorcher, number 83.
Fedorcher had 6 foot, 185 pounds. Needed to be about 6'6 to make that reception.
Yes, second down and 10 for Lehigh. Josh Snyder, number 7, checks into the lineup as a wide receiver for Lehigh. Stanball came in needing 331 yards to go over 10,000 for his career. But he'll pass up those numbers and take a win instead. Batted down at the line of scrimmage, Damon Sinacropi.
Well, the one thing you tell your defensive lineman, if you can't get back to the quarterback, as soon as you see the arm come forward, jump up. Damon Sinacropi knocking it to the ground. Stanball is going to go back. There's the block, number 92. Sinacropi again, coming up with a big play.
Sinacropi moments ago had the big pick. Now he gets the big paws up.
No push. Here's the effort. Get that right hand up.
Third down and 10 for Lehigh from its own 48-yard line. Shotgun, trail by 7. They go to the bread and butter for Dorcha. Very close. We'll have to see where the spot is made. Corrected. Brian Endler, 87.
Endler's going to make the reception very close to a first down. They'll bring in the chains right here in front of me. It's going to look slightly short.
You think so?
Good pass protection. There's Endler. He's going to make the reception, the second effort. Sinicropi downfield to make the stop.
Endler is a junior from Sidman, Pennsylvania.
If he is short, you know that Kevin Higgins will go for it on fourth, and he's short by at least a half a yard.
Well, 10:03 left. Went for it at the end of the first half, went for a fourth and goal from the one and missed. You know he's going for it here. You're down by seven.
And again, I think this is the situation. It's less than a half a yard. Give it to your strong quarterback. Let him do the sneak. Get that push by the front three.
Almost in the identical spot on the field with Stamble earlier on in this game, able to stretch it out for a first down. And Snyder is stuck. The big fullback is denied.
What a defensive stand today. James Emmanuel, number 44, comes up. But I like the defensive scheme. You move Magna. You move Sinicropi over to center. Watch the penetration. They come off the line. Stalemate. That's all you need as a defensive line. The stalemate, because then you let the linebackers do the rest. Penetration. Rob Leviatis, Jimmy Emmanuel, and number 22, Casey Mahoney. The three linebackers combined for the stop.
On downs, again, Hofstra takes over from its own 43-yard line with 9:51 left in the fourth. The Flying Dutchman with a 7-point lead. Inside handoff, Jimmy Jones spinning just shy of the 50-yard line.
And the question now, is it Jimmy Jones' time?
Hello, Mrs. Brown. Adam misses you.
Hello, Mrs. Brown. Adam misses you. That message, I guess, going down to Margate in Florida. In fact, Jimmy Emmanuel's got about 25 friends and family members up here. Included is his girlfriend, Dana Gavigan, who's an all-10, no, A-10 all-league soccer player at LaSalle. She's a junior. Reception made far side, Charlie Adams.
And you start to feel the momentum. You start to feel the confidence. Watch Charlie Adams down and out. Settles in. There's a soft defense. Comes up with the big reception. Carmazzi starting to put up some healthy numbers.
As is Adams, 13 yards on that catch, has 5 for 53 in this one. From the Lehigh 38, Hofstra goes with trips right. Shotgun Carmazzi, 8:45, clock is running. Morales, and the speed of Morales picking up about 4 extra yards to the 24-yard line. Run out of bounds by Ian Eason, 14-yard pickup.
Well, they scored a touchdown on this play in the first half. This time they go to number 11, Billy Morales. Watch Ian Eason, number 41, comes over to knock them out of bounds.
Morales has 4 catches for 49 yards. Spreading the wealth, Carmazzi, in this one. Jackson's got 10 catches, Adams got 5, Morales has 4. Jones right at the gut! Jones still on his feet to the 5-yard line!
Jimmy Jones takes it 19 yards right up the middle. He shifts it into high gear, kicks it in. Watch him wide, run through this line of scrimmage. 73, Michael Curry, there's the speed, the quickness, 19 yards. Jimmy Jones now over 19 carries, 115 yards.
First and goal, Hofstra from the Lehigh 6, pitch to Jimmy Jones. Oh! I think I got something on the way. Brian Appling Number 35 might get on the board.
Number 35 to tackle.
Let's look. Let's listen.
That E. Give Lehigh on the board.
Lehigh gets a daddy on the board. But still trailing the Hofstra daddy. More importantly, the stadium scoreboard. Lehigh down by 7. Second down and goal. Ball still at the 6. Quick pitch inside. Steve Jackson. Look at the end zone. Touchdown, Steve Jackson.
Number 21.
Steve Jackson takes the inside pitch. In for the touchdown. Good blocking downfield by the other wide receivers. They can take the inside pitch. It's the wide receiver, Steve Jackson. Second touchdown of the afternoon.
He ought to stay with football for now, despite wanting to perhaps one day be a model. Chad Johnson for the point after. 27-13, Flying Dutchman by 14 with 7:27 left in the fourth quarter. Steve Jackson, that 6-yard touchdown.
Hey, Grandma, how you doing? Derek, what's going on, baby? Got Dick from Chattanooga.
Chattanooga, the site of the national championship.
Another look at it. Play fake inside from Ozzie's reading the outside defender. Then he pitches it inside. The key block downfield, and then the good hustle by Steve Jackson. Second look at it. Block downfield is thrown by Billy Morales, number 88, Charlie Adams. And number 21, Steve Jackson, second touchdown of the afternoon. As you look at Steve Jackson's numbers, 144 yards now, two touchdowns.
That's today, Marty. Going back again over the last three, 31 catches, 482 yards, 5 touchdowns for Steve Jackson, who has become a money player. Now, Lehigh in a bind. Led from the get-go, quickly out of the box, 10-0. Hofstra has outscored Lehigh 27-3. Lehigh fans far side on their feet. Chad Johnson approaches. Ronald Jean from the 10. Ronald Jean, flag is down at the 20-yard line.
And I believe this would go against Lehigh blocking in the back.
Marty Lyons call is the correct one, as you see the indication from the referee, Jack Winter.
Sawalosi, number 49, in on the stop, a backup linebacker.
Illegal block in the back, on the run back, by the receiving team, first down.
Wow, backs it all the way up to the 9-yard line.
Carmazzi once again leading the Flying Dutchman down the field. 57 yards, less than 2.5 minutes.
That's the 90-yard line. First and 10.
There's Mike Rossigno, big number 55, who they haven't needed today. And that's
probably
a good
sign.
They probably won't need him, and which only helps him get healthy. There's the big hug, Rossigno, Steve Jackson. He was very disappointed, and you could see in Rossigno when I spoke to him yesterday, you're hoping that the team wins
time
so
out.
You get an opportunity
Lehigh
to play next week.
Rossigno is a blue-collar worker. He would stay in there, and probably Joe Gardy should have given him a little bit of rest prior to, you know, him continuing to go out there and bang himself around. But a true competitor.
Timeout on the field with 7:16 left in the fourth quarter. We're coming right back.
When is a cable company more than a cable company? When they have a staff like this. Technology like this. Choices like this. And a name like this. When is a cable company more than a cable company? When they give you more than cable. Cablevision.
Enthusiasm, pride, excitement. That's athletics at Hofstra University and the spirit of the Hofstra Pride Club. Through scholarships and facility improvements, the Hofstra Pride Club helps give our student athletes the winning edge. Pride Club membership puts you on the inside track of the Hofstra athletics program with season ticket discounts and much more. Make a difference in a young person's life. Come, share the pride. Call 516-463-5339.
This moment of romance was brought to you by the Westbury Manor.
14-point lead for the third seed in this tournament, the Flying Dutchman over Lehigh, 27-13. And the big numbers are the two on the right.
First down.
Over the middle, picking up about 7 yards.
Rick Moore all over the field today, comes down with another reception, very close to a first down. Tackled there by number 37, Joe Todd, and number 35, Rob Levitis. Busy afternoon. Give him 9 yards on the reception.
Second down and one for Lehigh. Really gonna have to gear it up in this passing game now. Clock is against them. Stamball nearly slipped, regains composure, and then able to scramble for that first down. Hofstra going for the strip.
But again, good coverage downfield by the secondary of the Flying Dutchman. Nowhere to throw the ball. Look at number 43. Adam Brown, you have to give this young man a lot of credit. 2 years ago, he was injured, missed most of the season. Last year, again, he got injured. This year, he comes back and relatively healthy the whole time.
The reverse to Brant Hall.
And Brant Hall, if he could have kept his feet, he was trying to throw the ball.
Because he is the backup quarterback to Phil Stambaugh.
Here it is, the handoff to number 18. Brant Hall, he goes back, you see, he's trying to set himself, whoops! Slides out. Second and 19.
Ball at the 15 of Lehigh. Drilled, catch made by Endler to the 20-yard line. This is still going to be third and long, with 5:35 left in what looks like the end of Lehigh's season.
Endler's gonna make the reception. Gets credit for picking up 7 yards.
Oh, right to the sticks. That is a smart receiver. Cody Fedorcha got a yard behind the marker, then able to step out of bounds to stop the clock.
And that's one thing you don't want to do, is give up a long play. Stambaugh looks out, looks to his right. Fedorcha, right there, knows how far he has to get, and he picks up a first down.
Ronald Jean can't hold on. Clock stops with 5:08 left.
Second and 10.
So Lehigh on second down and 10, down by 14 from its own 37. Far side, getting out of bounds after the catch, number 7, Josh Snyder.
Snyder doing the smart thing, takes the short pass, makes the reception, gets out of bounds. sets up a third and three situation. Timeouts remaining. Hofstra has all three of theirs. Wide Lehigh down to one.
That will cost them.
Joe Todd making a strong tackle. Not good enough for a daddy, though, on this one. Joe Todd.
Ho-ho.
Stanball goes back. The pass, the catch by Ricky Moore again, and then the stop.
Joe Todd doing Mansfield, Massachusetts proud. The junior, 6 foot, 220 pounds, the junior linebacker. Looking home run, looking back to the side, the reception is made, and a flag, I think, for Dortra. I don't know, they're going to call offensive or defensive? Lindy Washington?
Got to be on number two, Lindy Washington reaching up and grabbing.
I disagree.
Well, we'll see who's right.
Pass interference on the defense, decline.
I think it's against Lehigh. And I disagree with you, Marty.
You just heard the call.
I heard the call, but I don't have to agree with the ref. Watch.
Look at it. Watch it again.
Watch the push-off by 83.
Watch the hand right there. There's the hand, the first hand, and then the hold. The jersey comes down. Fedorcic is just trying to defend this territory, and then he makes the reception.
How can you fight a guy that played defense for his entire career, huh? How can you fight that guy?
An excellent job, but the quarterback Stanball is going to throw it into the middle of traffic, tries to force this one in.
Third pick in the game suffered by Stanball, fifth pick of the season for Doug Shanahan.
And you're not going to believe if this is a double penalty.
Personal foul here. Okay.
Okay.
We have another personal foul here. We have another personal foul here.
Wow.
Three fouls, and you know who they had down on the ground if we can take another look at it. Number two, the littlest guy on the field, Ron Jean.
So negate the fifth pick of the year.
Wow, that's very surprising. I thought that came after the interception.
We have a personal foul on the run back, declined. Personal foul on the run back, declined. Then we have a personal foul on the run back. Half the distance to the goal, first down.
Wow.
Wow.
Lehigh.
See, but it was after the interception.
It was after the interception, so it will
right.
stand.
Right, so it comes back from the point.
So
it's
correct.
A spot foul, but Joe Gardy's offense keeps the ball.
So Shanahan, the sophomore from Farmingville, New York, is credited with his fifth pick of the season. But Hofstra pinned back at its own 7 yard line. There was movement.
Michael Curry, 73, moved prior to the snap.
There is Shanahan, the two sport athlete.
False start. Offense. First down.
Another look at the interception. Phil Stanball, he's going to go back. Watch. Throws it right into the middle of pressure. Rides on the back. Doug Shanahan's going to make the interception, his fifth of the season. Then he takes it outside. Smart thing to do. Just get out of bounds.
So the midfielder on the Hofstra lacrosse team, pick number 5 on the season. Everybody's saying hello to their mother today.
You see the margin of turnovers, 3-1 today. They came in plus 11.
First down and 13. Joe Gardy talking to linebackers coach Bob McIntyre. Wow. Colgate out of the Patriot League. Looks like Red Raiders are going home. The Red Birds all over the Red Raiders. Trips near side for the Flying Dutchman. First and 13. From the four. Jones spins to about the 11-yard line.
Jimmy Jones, those little tiny steps.
Number 90, Michael Emery, the senior.
4 minutes.
And the clock is running. So it appears for the first time in school history, the Hofstra Flying Dutchman will win a 1AA playoff game. Lost in 95, lost in 97, but in 1999 will be victorious in the first round. Jones again, wrestled, hot tied there by pick number 91 for Lehigh, Roy Mathis, a sophomore from Tallahassee, Florida. Somebody yelled hey about eight times and nobody responded. Third down and six. Kevin Higgins, 2 years in a row, great job with this program. Now in his sixth season. Trips near side on third and six. Keep it on the ground with Jimmy Jones to be short of that first down. David Pettit, number 94, the tackle. Lehigh calling its last timeout with 2:41 left. So if they're gonna get it done, they have to get it done in a hurry.
Well, they're gonna come all out, try to block this punt.
Yep.
2:41, no timeouts left. Joe Gardy has to tell his punt team now, hey, give ourselves enough time to punt the ball, good protection up front, and tell McCleary, get it out of there as quick as possible.
Oh, don't forget tonight, the Islanders at home, right across the street at the Nassau Coliseum, taking on the Capitals. Get all the action going with Geico Islanders game night at 6:30. Then it's the Caps and Islanders at 7 on MSG. Caps and Islanders, there's the building, the Nassau Coliseum. So that game in about 3.5 hours with the pregame at 6:30.
And Joe Gardy throwing a little wrinkle here. Chad Johnson back to do the punt.
Well, he said that Chad Johnson does have a foot if need be. And he's going to take the safety. He's going to run it out of the end zone. He's going to just get, there it is. I don't know if I'm giving a team points.
Well, when you think about it, now you get to go up and place it. Now, Chad Johnson, you're going to back yourself out.
So you agree with that call, give up the two with 2:33 left.
Would have punted the ball.
Well, I guess he feels that Lehigh's got a real good special team with blocking punts. Why risk the punt, maybe blocked into the end zone and recover for a touchdown? That might be, now to think about it, could be a smart move.
And I think at this point of the game, the best thing Joe Gardy can do is field position. You're going to get great field position now. Send Chad Johnson back out. Nope. You're going to send McCleary out. Have him get a good high punt. You'll get the field position that you need. And remember, Lehigh still down by 12 points. It is a two-possession, two-score game.
And Lehigh, remember, no timeouts. Hofstra has all three of its timeouts left. The scenario, there is Ronald Jean. Can he get his hands on one and bust it?
Well, the key here is for McCleary to get the ball high enough that the punt coverage team can
can do their jobs. And when you look out there, they got some special team players out there that will hit you, especially number 26, Doug Shanahan. 37 is Joe Todd.
You have Chris Crank out there, number four as well.
Sawalosi, there's the kick.
Takes a bounce. Burks will let it go. That's a free ball, isn't it, Marty? Or not. That's Jason Howard running it in, but they've just got to be able to down that. That is not like an onside kick.
You can't advance it,
but it is Hofstra's ball.
And there's one of the young men we talked about, number 48, Jason Howard. You can come down, you can recover it, you can't advance it. And this game is history. Everybody looking up, nobody knowing what to do. And there's the good hustle and speed by number 48, Jason Howard. Armazi's gonna go back out to finish up the game with 2:25. He'll take a knee and let this one run out.
Well, it turns out to be a genius move by Coach Joe Gardy, taking the safety, gets the free kick, and now his team gets possession.
And you really got to give Joe Gardy a lot of credit. When their team struggled early, there was no panic. He kept his boys together, kept the coaching staff really focused, and as a result, they're going to advance next week.
And we will have that game for you. Check your local listings. It will be on the Metro Learning Channel. The Metro Sports, just check for the time. Next week, Hofstra hosting, in all probability, Illinois State. Jimmy Jones slides inside the 25-yard line.
And now if you're a player, you go in and you start the mentality of, we needed four games to get the national championship. Now we're down to three.
One game at a time. Jim Emanuel, an outstanding effort. He went home last night with game tape. He said, I'll stay up all night and just look at it and concentrate on what I need to do. Obviously, he did one heck of a job breaking down Lehigh's film.
And Rob Levitis, Joe Todd, but give that whole defense. Chip Carver did an excellent job. Their backs early in the game were against the wall. The offense turnover, special team turnover. Nobody pointing fingers, just going out there and getting the job done.
It was a little jittery at the beginning. Hofstra trailed 10-0, but then all of a sudden the offense got it into gear, lost some of those butterflies. Composure set in. Jimmy Jones, outstanding effort. Steve Jackson, outstanding effort. Jimmy Jones, 138 yards today on 25 carries. Steve Jackson, 11 for 144 receiving. Nobody will ever forget Ronald Jean, Marty. He didn't have the numbers today, 16 carries, 52 yards and a touchdown, but everybody fell in love with this guy because of what he went through as a child, and he's earned his spot nationally.
And Carl, what I've learned to respect about Ron Jean is, you know what, it's not how tall you are. He's 5'6". He's much of a man, big heart, and he should be an inspiration, not just to people that want to play the game of football. He made a positive impact in the game of life. He proved that a lot of times when people quit on you, when your own mother quits on you, if you believe in yourself, you can accomplish the goals that you set forth. And we commend you, Ron Jean, for an outstanding performance on the football field, but more importantly, what you did in life.
Couldn't say it any better, Marty, as Kevin Higgins, Joe Gardy exchange handshakes, the Flying Dutchman. This one in the books by the final of 27-15, and there is celebration in Hempstead, New York, because the Flying Dutchman will move on to the next round of the 1AA playoffs.